I'm Professor Chris Melhuish. I'm the director of the Bristol Robotics Laboratory, which is a partnership between the University of the West of England and the University of Bristol. Well, one of the research areas that we're very, very keen on exploring is the link between humans and robots, so human-robot interaction. In a way, how can we get robots to live with us, and how can we work with robots in easy ways, the ways that we're sort of used to working with other humans. And what we don't want to do is, if you want to work with a robot, you don't want to have to write a piece of code, or sit down at a computer and type something. You just want to interact with it in the way that you would. Although we find that very, very simple, actually getting a machine to do that is proving to be very, very difficult. Well, Jules is part of a research initiative in exploring facial expressions. We often think about facial expressions being extremes. You know, I'm very, very happy or I'm very sad. But in fact, most of the time, our facial expressions are quite subtle. Now, where Jules has been successful, it's in exploring the ideas of natural expressions. One of the problems is that you don't want a robot which has robotic expressions. It's either happy or sad. So it's that dynamic element of facial expression that we're trying to work on. Well, the future for Jules is to continue with the work and get better, and also then to integrate it into a larger torso, a robot platform that we'll be using. So we'll be integrating the head and also other elements of gesturing and vision, things like that.
I don't know, what do you think?
Bert is part of a research program which looks at gesturing. Gesturing is extremely important, again, for an interaction where we're emphasizing things, or we might be even pointing and using what we refer to as indexicals. So you'd say, give me that, and give it here. I want it now. Or you might be emphasizing a particular point. Now, those are the things which go on all the time when we interact with each other. In fact, interesting enough, if you take them away, then it looks odd. But most of the time, of course, we don't actually realize that we're doing it. So that needs to be involved in our integrated platform and integrated robot as well.
He started, but I stopped him.
Of course, the research that we're doing with Bert will lead into this integrated system as well. So eventually, we hope to have a robot which will include lots of these elements. So gesturing, it will include facial expressions, the non-language utterances, body pose, and of course, speech as well.